full time at the Emirates Stadium, Arsenal 2, West Ham United 0. And that is a big win, a big result. Firstly, of course, in terms of the Premier League, our standing in the table, we move up into fourth position. It's a win over a team we're in direct competition with for a European place. But I kind of think above and beyond that, it's a really big win because it is a necessary and valuable reminder of the young talent that exists in this group. I'm going to list some players now and their respective ages. Gabriel Martinelli, 20. Bukayo Saka, 20. Emile Smith-Rowe, 21. Martin Odegaard, 22. You've got an entire defensive unit, a back four and a goalkeeper, all age 24 or under. I think Gabriel, Tomiyasu and Ramsdale still only 23. And I haven't mentioned Albert Zabilakonga, a player already on the fringes of the full Belgian squad who's really impressed for us in the Premier League. Nuno Tavares, who came on again tonight. The 11 that finished the game, it was pointed out by Kai Kainak on Twitter, had an average age of just over 23. Something that I think happened when we lost those two painful games against Manchester United and Everton is that I think in the disappointment, in the frustration, I think we forgot about how good the good moments have felt this season. And when I think about those good moments, I think about the win over Tottenham in the North London Derby. I think about the game against Aston Villa. I think about the game at Leicester, particularly the first half performance. Because in those moments, yes, we saw a team that we liked, a team that we identify with, a team that we can connect with as fans, I think in a way that we haven't done for quite a long time. But also a team that we really do believe has big potential. And I think, I don't want to go fully the other way now and say everything's fine, everything's good, we're going to canter into the top four. You know that's not my opinion. But I do think that we lost perspective as a fan base in that period. And I think that many of the good things, the good developments that we've seen over the course of the last few months were discarded. And I think tonight was a valuable reminder of some of those. And there were things we did better tonight. There were differences. I thought there was an intensity about the team that we've not always had. I thought the way we pressed, harried and worked from the front, we haven't always done. But we were really at it. And we went into the half-time at 0-0. I thought Arteta was right to stick with the same team, and I think the first half performance demonstrated that. We probably deserved more than what we got. I think we were lacking a little bit of quality, a little bit of finesse in the final third. But I could have no complaints because of the work rate, the desire, the intention to play that was there in the team. I thought in the first half, Bukayo Saka was exemplary. He gave Masuaku all sorts of problems, as you would expect him to do, as we've become accustomed to seeing him do, to all kinds of left-backs. I thought Martin Odegaard had some really sublime touches, really impressed me in that first half. Martinelli worked hard, as you would expect. I thought Tomiyasu was very good. But, you know, there were moments where West Ham threatened on the break or where we didn't quite have that finishing touch. We didn't have that last pass. We didn't have the shot. Second half started and I was a little bit fearful. I thought, can we maintain that intensity? Are we going to regret not taking the opportunities that came our way in the first half? But what a goal we scored early on to settle some of those concerns. Brilliant ball from Lacazette, who I thought did very well tonight as a centre forward. Yes, he missed a penalty, but I thought his link play was good. He worked hard, he won free kicks, he won a penalty too. And the way Martinelli comes onto it, one touch, finish, bang. A lot of people will point out it reminds them of Thierry Henry because it's in that inside left channel. I'll go into this more probably tomorrow on the Arsecast, but it reminded me of somebody else. It reminded me of Theo Walcott. And I know Thierry Henry is more of a compliment, but there's something about the directness of Walcott, that willingness to run in behind and always be focused on end product. I think in Walcott's case, it was almost like he had to focus on that because that was really where his strengths lay. I think Martinelli has more all-round ability than that, but in a similar respect, he is a finisher, he is a provider, he is someone who, when he gets into that final 18 yards of the pitch, is thinking about the goal. I think that's really valuable to this team. And it's an interesting conundrum how you fit all these young attacking players in together. We'll come to that later maybe. But so that was 1-0. West Ham came back into it as you would kind of expect. I know there is this pattern of Arsenal sitting off when they're in the lead, maybe not exerting enough control. I think with the stakes being high tonight, you could kind of understand that. But the game swung really after that on the penalty decision. I've seen David Moyes said he thought it was a penalty. I'm a little bit surprised that was his perspective. I think there is a very good case that it's a penalty and I'll absolutely take it. Second booking was really the crucial thing. Because obviously Lacazette doesn't score, which in a way, if you don't think it's a penalty, is a kind of justice. But the red card has happened by that point. It's been given second booking and off goes Soufal. So that helped, no doubt about it. What else helped? West Ham decided to play Mikel Antonio as a right back for most of the game. Very grateful for that. Please feel free to do that every time we play you. And then the game sort of changed because West Ham had to chase an equaliser, but they had a man short. We had a threat on the break. Smith Rowe came on from Odegaard to add to that threat on the break, and what a brilliant goal he scored. Really was fantastic. Tomiyasu did well to win it. Saka did well to carry it. Laid it off to Smith Rowe. Drove towards goal. Finished from outside the box. Just beautiful. On his left foot. Another goal for him. 10 goals between him and Odegaard for the season. Before Christmas. So you'll absolutely take that. They're sharing that responsibility. I think there are more goals to come from Saka. I think Martinelli showing he can score goals is promising. Because there's one notable goal scorer who hadn't been scoring goals for us and may not be back in the team for a while. So we're going to need these guys. But yeah, I just really was thrilled to get the result. I thought we would beat West Ham. I've said it for some time now. I saw this on the horizon. I think this team are much more comfortable at home than they are away. That needs to change. It won't change overnight. It will take time. But real signs for encouragement. Positive goal difference now as well, which is very overdue, very welcome. But yeah, it does seem crazy to me, I have to be honest, that a week ago a lot of people were talking about sacking the manager. We've lost 3 of our last 16 games. We're in fourth position, later than we have been for the last few years in a Premier League season. Yes, there are tough fixtures ahead, and yes, we will lose more games, we will drop more points, that is certain. But I think we can see a direction, a positive future for this group, and I don't think it's possible to fully separate that from the manager. And I'll tell you why. Because Ramsdale, Tomiyasu, Odegaard, these are guys in which Lokonga, in which he played a significant role in the recruitment. If you're happy they're here, you've got to give some credit to the manager. Saka, Smith Rowe, ultimately, these are people that under his management really became first team players. Martinelli, we've all been saying he's been holding him back. Does he deserve more opportunities? Why isn't he in the team? I don't know, maybe he knew what he was doing. Martinelli does seem to have added more depth, more variety to his game. Again, I'm not saying he's a perfect manager. He's not at all. But I just don't, at this point, see a reasonable reason, to repeat a word, to terminate things. And I think something I've banged on about for a long time is that I think being a football fan, you know, every team in the Football League, bar one, doesn't win the Premier League. Everybody could be doing better. We could all demand more. We could all expect more. And at Arsenal, those expectations are particularly high. But you can't always win as a fan. So what's important is that you believe in what's happening in some way, that you that you like what you see, that you like the players, that you like the group, and crucially, that you think tomorrow it could be better. I think when that hope dies, you're not having a fun time, and that's when things have got to change. But I really have that hope this season. I really have it. And it's based so much on those young players. I do think that this is a project. I know people hate that word. I don't say the word process, but it's a project, and it's one that deserves, that warrants commitment over a period of time. And I really hope that you don't have to do, you can do whatever you want. I was gonna say, I hope we can all get on board with that. You don't have to, you can think whatever you like. I'm on board. I think there are gonna be ups and downs this season. I still think, ultimately, if we're in the race for top four against a very experienced Manchester United side, they may come up better, you know? If we don't have Aubameyang, if we need another centre forward, and Ronaldo's firing for United and Kane's firing for Spurs, it might be difficult. I still believe that we're making very obvious progress. I just do. Like, people say, oh, well, some of the problems in the team are the same as the problems we had last year. Yeah, maybe. Maybe. I see the sort of statistical case for that. But these players will be better next year than they are this year. And we haven't been able to say that about an Arsenal team with any great conviction for quite a long time. That really matters. You want to believe it's going to be better tomorrow. I do believe that. But today also feels very nice. I've been... when you're a positive person and they lose, you sort of have to hold it in. You have to sort of be like, oh yeah, no, things are awful. So then when they have a good moment, you have a bit of release, and I've had a bit of release tonight. Probably I'm a bit over the top, but it's who I am, it's what I think. Right, I'm gonna leave it there. This is really long. I never do it this long. Bye.